think I've told you guys this before, but I remember writing that song. It was a hard time in our lives. We were just trying to get away, and we drove out to Jacksonville Beach, and we're walking on the beach, and you know, what's the old saying? You didn't have a pot or a window, or you follow me? I mean, things were tough, tough, tough. And I just remember just finally saying, God, you know what? If none of this other stuff changes around me, you are more than enough for me. I can put my hope in you. I can put my trust in you. I don't know how to fix all this, God, but you know how to fix it, Lord. So you are more than enough for me. And that's where this song was birthed. And I love to sing it to him because even though the dynamics of my life have changed, how many know he is not? He's still the same. And it doesn't matter if I have a little or a lot, he's still all I need.
Oh,
would you lift your hands and just tell them, Father God, we just want to be with you. We thank you that you're pouring your presence out on us. We thank you that your presence, God, changes things. You can't remain depressed in his presence. You're pouring out peace tonight, and we receive it now. We open ourselves up for you, God. Begin to move in our lives. Begin to take addictions right off of our tongue, God. Desires that don't please you, God, begin to remove them. Begin to recalibrate our heart, God. I thank you that our roots, our spirit roots, are growing deep tonight. We declare to them now to begin to take root in the soil, that we might grow, God, to be strong trees of righteousness.
Unfortunately, in our King James Version of the Bible, they got the punctuation wrong. they didn't legitimately, accurately convey the original text, because we expect the enemy to come in like a flood. And then once the enemy is flooding us, then God then is this last minute God for us. And the truth of the matter is that the original translation is when the enemy comes in, period. Actually, the grammar's not a period, it's a comma. When the enemy comes in, if he shows his face, God's coming in like a flood. So when the enemy starts showing his head in your life, you don't need to look for a flood from the enemy. You need to look for a flood from God. You need to start changing your perspective that if the enemy's doing anything in my life, there's a flood in here. And the flood is from God. And the flood is from the kingdom. And the flood is from goodness and grace and mercy. Premier, pristine example of what it all looks like. Because listen, let's look at the Bible, okay? The Bible is our standard. I've been doing this, and I'm talking about it on Sunday, and I thank God for our country, and I thank God for our Constitution, but I'm about the Bible. That's my standard of holiness and my standard of living. The Bible didn't send them to the government for help. Established the church.